So we're back.
The Panthers.
We're back for period two with me, Paul Wheeler, and Chris Beal.
AKA Dave Sims and Rick Strachan.
We are the Sims and Strachan of the ENL, only better.
And the puck now dumped down the right-hand side for Bukas to collect as the Whitley Warriors still on the power play in this second period. They're leading 1-0 after a goal in the first period from Callum Watson after only 5 minutes. Adam Reynolds loses the puck to Leggard. Leggard will chase with but Williams in support. Leggard tries to feed him, doesn't manage to. 20 seconds remaining on the penalty kill for the Blaze, but Williams with a big shove into the boards. He gets called.
And that's got to be boarding.
I think it is. The Whitley player hasn't stood up yet. We're waiting to see if he's all right.
And this could be a serious blow for both Whitley and for the ENL Blaze.
Indeed. The coach telling Adam Reynolds to have a word with the referee. The Whitley player has stayed down. We didn't see who it was. But it does look like he's suffering a little.
Hold on a minute. I'm just doing a check down the bench.
He hasn't moved by the looks of it. We obviously can't see him down there because he's covered. He's up now onto his feet by the looks of it.
He's going to have to be helped up.
Daniel Harris by the looks of it. And that looks nasty for Daniel Harris.
That really does look nasty.
Wasn't the dirtiest of hits from Reece Williams. It was from behind, so it was questionable. And
now here on SITV, we're seeing played out the question that's been plaguing hockey all over the world at the moment. Hits like that, and what do you do about them?
By the looks of it, but Williams has only received a two-minute penalty. So he's got off very lightly indeed there, I think, Chris.
Well,
2 minutes for boarding only.
I think the Warriors will feel a little hard done by that, because a hit like that, they'll probably feel that accidental or malicious or whatever. McWilliams should have probably gone out of the game for a hit like that.
Indeed, because the way Daniel Harris left the ice, I don't think we'll be seeing him back, certainly in this game, and possibly not tomorrow either. It remains to be seen. We'll see if we can get an update on his condition.
But now quite possibly one of the most experienced lineup possibly for the ENL Blaze out now on the penalty kill. Antti Kovacka, Tom Pease and James Pease.
Also,
Gareth Owen.
Will be interesting to see if the Whitley Warriors try and take any sort of revenge on Reece Williams. They are no shrinking violets, Whitley, when it comes to physical play. Here they come, though, with Andy Thornton. Kevin Bukas, another former Newcastle Viper, had a brief spell with them. Windridge outdeeks himself in his own zone. Now, the puck is with Kovacka, who will wank that one round the boards as hard as he possibly can. Lavelle.
Well, the ENL Blaze this week in training and last week working a lot on situations like this on the penalty kill. So it will be interesting to see how the training works out here.
Here comes Ross Venus, supported by Kovacka. 45 seconds remaining on the penalty kill to Reece Williams. Here is Venus. He'll look to try and take time off the clock. Shot from Kovacka. Flavelle has to use the blocker to make a save there. Antti Kovacka too has something of a cannon from the point. We mentioned Tom and James Pease earlier on. Lots of hard shooters for Flavelle to face from the ENL Blaze blue line. 20 seconds remaining on this penalty kill. And so far the Whitley Warriors, touch wood if you're an ENL Blaze fan, haven't really done that much. On this power play, Selwood will dump that one around the boards. 5 seconds remaining. Nicklin will try and get that one out the zone ahead of Brummett. He doesn't manage to, though. Tom Pease collects, gets it out the zone. The ENL Blaze return to full strength. Reece Williams returns to the ice to a mixed reception, shall we say. Whitley Warriors fans in the crowd less than impressed with him after his hit on Daniel Harris. And the question is, Chris, as the ENL Blaze come up the ice, do you think Whitley will try and take revenge on McWilliams, or do you think that...
Very possibly. He's got three Whitley players now standing over him. But I'm going to tell you now, that won't intimidate Reece McWilliams.
Reece McWilliams...
He's tangled with the toughest of them.
He has. He doesn't know the meaning of the word fear, Reasonable Williams, I don't think.
And his comebacks are like a switchblade. They hit you from nowhere.
And as has happened once or twice this season, if he can't cut you down to size with his tongue, he may well do so with his fist, Reasonable Williams. He's a tough cookie.
As Ben Davidson of the Northern Stars found out a few weeks back.
Indeed. Shall we return to hockey now?
Yes, we shall return to hockey.
Installing the virtues of our captain.
But at the moment, Blaine Evans in conference with...
Sean Kippen, that is, he's having a word with. Kippen grinning. He obviously enjoyed the conversation. Shot from Mahmoud. It's tip wide by Flavelle. But Williams... expect him to be the target of the odd body check from Whitley Warriors as they look to take legal retribution. Zajac takes the puck into the zone though, and he will try and feed Robinson. Robinson posts one through. That one goes off the back of the post, I think.
A couple of inches inside further, and that would have been a goal. Gareth Owen now collects the puck at the blue line.
Unfortunately for the ENL Blaze, there was a nobody could get up to him in support quickly enough. Owen gets it back though. Plays that one all the way along the blue line. It stays inside the zone. Now it's out though. Mahmoud will take that one back in. Now Robinson comes the other way. Supported by Ryder. Ryder shoots. Good save, Josh Nichols. It's still free though. They're digging away. Eventually Nichols manages to get that covered up. Philip Pollock having a word.
And Pollock and Gareth Owen in there, two players who are not afraid also to drop the gloves.
Good for the ENL Blaze to see them protecting Josh Nichols. Obviously, anybody who's ever watched or played hockey will tell you that you go after a goalie and you can expect several of the goalie's teammates coming after you in return.
Either that or you'll have the goalie coming after you. I've had that experience personally this year a couple of times in my league.
And with Josh Nichols, let's face it, it may well be the goalie coming after you. Here's Venus though, centres it. Lavelle spreads himself all the way across the net with those long legs of his, and doesn't have to make a save because the puck goes straight across over to the far side. It's now back in the original corner, pulled in by Hubbock in the zone. James Pease tries to centre it, can't find Venus though. Venus will go over and chase that. Pressured by Windridge. Back to the point. Tom Pease winds one up, fires. Lavelle covers it. And that was Venus looking to pick up any trash in front. Unceremoniously dumped by Adam Reynolds.
He has been the target of a lot of physical play this evening, Ross Venus.
But he can take that. One of the ENL Blaze stars, arguably. He spent most of his time in the Elite League this season.
And that class is definitely showing through. You can see why Paul Thompson called him up for so long as a replacement during that injury spell.
Meanwhile, the puck is over with James Pease, also a Coventry Blaze stalwart. He will dump that one in. Nicklin will chase Brummett, as will Stevenson. Neither of them lands a hit. Brummett will just lay a drop pass. Binyarski nearly intercepts. By hook or by crook, the Warriors get the puck out the zone. But it comes straight back at them. Nicklin is free. If a swipe stick can get to it, Nicklin winds one up, shoots and hits the side netting. The crowd over that side thought it was in. There was a loud cheer.
Well, they saw net ruffling.
I'm quite impressed the goal light didn't go on then. He's got twitchy fingers at that end, we said in the first period. When somebody actually hits the net, albeit on the wrong side, the light doesn't go on.
But Lavelle is showing signs of being a bit shaky here.
Adding
and as we say that, a penalty to the Whitley Warriors. Number 14, Ali Brummett.
He's one of their key defensemen, Ali Brummett, one of their bigger defensemen. He'll sit down for 2 minutes at 5:09.
2 minutes for getting a little bit too over excited with the stick.
Indeed, cross-checking for Ali Brummett. So the ENL Blaze will go on the power play. The puck has left the ice.
over in front of the Blaze bench.
So I'm calling for delay of game there against Whitley Warriors, Adam Reynolds.
I'd have been very surprised if Blaine Evans had called that. Whatever other criticisms he may get, he does know the rules very well, Blaine Evans, and is very sure of his calls, never makes a call unless he's sure of it, even if some of the other people it's called on aren't. Now, Kovacka in his own zone, tries to beat Gareth Owen, poke checked back to Josh Nichols, and the Blaze have to start again. 5:37 gone in the second period. 30 seconds gone on the power play. 1-0 still to the Whitley Warriors. And they're just not connecting at the moment, the Blaze. They wind up now with Kovacka, tries to lead his team forward again. Now, leg guard is checked hard in the corner. Good and clean.
But he's up, quick.
Gavin Papps can't control that one. There's a foot race, and it's Daniel Good. It's 2-0, Watson. Nice hands, Callum Watson, that's 2-0. Short-handed goal, the Whitley Warriors break away. And you've got to feel sorry for Josh Nichols there.
You really do. He did all he could to stop that. When you're a goalie and you're 2-0 like that, all you can do is put yourself down and hope that the puck somehow does not get through your five hole. And unfortunately, that's exactly what it did.
Josh Nichols left more exposed than me when my pants ripped on Blackpool Beach. So 2-0 now for the Wheeler. Whitley Warriors. They still have 59 seconds remaining on this power play. Short-handed goal, Callum Watson assisted Daniel Good.
And it becomes even more key than ever now for the Blaze to score the next goal.
That's his second of the night, Callum Watson. Now, Venus, Stevenson, Hubbock, Pease. Tries to dump it round. The ENL Blaze look like they've had the air taken out of their sails a bit by that short-handed goal. And here come the Whitley Warriors again on the penalty kill. Watson already for two goals tonight. Skates in, shoots Callum Watson this time. Josh Nichols makes a very good save. Venus goes down, no whistle.
That should have been a tripping call.
And no call made by Blaine Evans. So ENL Blaze will continue. Here is James Pease. Winds one up, shoots James Pease. It's padded away by Flavelle. Tom Pease is hooked. Loses control of the puck. His brother waits at the point. And Tom Pease finds him. James Pease now gets a shot. Stevenson tries to pat that down. Warriors are now back to full strength after that unsuccessful power play for the Blaze. Very unsuccessful one. They actually lost the goal instead of scoring one. And there's a scrum of humanity over in the corner. Pile of thriving humanity. Here comes Daniel Good. No, it isn't. It's Daniel Harris back on the ice. Pleasing.
Glad to see he has recovered after that hit earlier.
And it's free. Good save. Josh Nichols is still free in front of him. Eventually cleared. Nichols having to make a lot of saves from point blank range at the moment. Nicklin on his own as the rest of his line mates go for a change. Pollock wants a slap shot, doesn't get it. Mahmoud tries to get one off on net, doesn't manage to though, and it will be dumped in.
And the Warriors have really seriously upped the tempo here right now.
And they have. You're starting to see why perhaps they are so lethal. And when ENL North at a canter, they nearly tip one in. Good save, Josh Nichols. Throws himself full length, that tip from Peter Zajac, I think it was, in front of the net.
I think Andy Thornton not happy about something that occurred there in front of the crease, just putting his arms up in the air and saying to Blaine Evans, what was that?
Ryan Selwood gives Josh Nichols a bang on the pads. He's keeping the ENL Blaze in this game at the moment. 2-0 in favour of the Whitley Warriors. And the puck will go off the boards. Selwood will clear it. 2-on-2 now, briefly. Leg guard and McWilliams, but Williams shoots, Flavelle saves. That's something you'll hear us say a few times over the next game and a half or so.
Flavelle is giving up rebounds like Christmas presents, and there's just nobody getting on the end of them at the moment.
Here is McWilliams again, though. Over in the corner. Venus is checked into the corner as well. There's a Warrior down. Eventually gets himself back up. Shot from Venus, blocked. Venus is flattened again. As the Warriors go for the shot, short side. Flavelle doesn't know where it is. And the net's off. So that one won't count. In fairness, I think that was a little optimistic from McWilliams trying to get a goal out of that one, because the net was well off then.
The net was well off. And poor Antti Kovacka celebrating in the crease, having just potted the puck when the net was miles off its mooring.
At least we know Antti can hit the net.
It's not his fault, though, to be fair, in that situation. You're looking at the puck, you're not looking at the net.
Rueful smile from the Finnish veteran. Now, Nicklin. Stop trying to cycle the puck, Josh Nicklin. Feeds Finjarski in the corner. Finjarski trying to work his way out, finds Stevenson. This line working well so far tonight. Possible trip on Stevenson, not given. Well kept in. James Pease playing football. And Nicklin digs the puck free. Josh Nicklin, free. Tip Flavelle hasn't covered it. Now he has. But just for a half second, the puck was free.
He does seem to be panicking a little bit when they're getting in close on him, Flavelle, at the moment.
And Reesville Williams was there, lurking.
Telling you now, if the ENL are going to score, it's going to be a garbage goal.
We'll see if it's this shift where the ENL Blaze take out the trash. Shot from Venus, it's blocked. That was Peeves, in fact. Was it Paps? We'll get there eventually.
I believe it's Paps.
It was Kieran Paps. We'll get there eventually. We'll run through the whole roster.
Because I can see Peas on the bench right now.
It wouldn't be a scorched ice broadcast if we didn't make one mistake. It's now three with Pollock. Fires it across. No one can get a tip in though. Now, long pass. Paps miscontrols it and immediately Windridge is in there chasing.
That has been half of the Blazers' problem today. It's just been miscontrolled or mistimed passes.
We're now halfway through the first leg, quarter of the way through this ENL playoff final. And Whitley, at the moment, have the advantage, 2-0 up. Two goals from Callum Watson, the first after 5 minutes, the second a short-handed goal, 2-0 breakaway with DJ Good. Pollock, though, coming the other way, winds one up, shoot Pollock wide. Tom Pease will dump that one softly into the corner. Owen elects not to chase it.
I think Owen was looking for the line change there, possibly.
He collects the puck now. James Pease. Drop pass. That will be icing. It's waved off. Linesman saying it touched Kevin Bukas's stick. So Binyarski will try and play it. Doesn't manage to, though. Stevenson has his stick held by Zajac, so can't get to that one. Now Harris tries a centering pass. Doesn't manage to find anyone, though. James Pease has to go back and collect it. That puck goes all the way across the zone. Bukas will flip one in over the top. Nichols covering his post. Whistle from Blade Evans. Has he called hooking there, Chris? I was trying to misinterpret
the
signal.
No, I don't think he's called anything. I think it's just... I think it's because he lost sight of the puck, maybe. I'm not sure. Or possibly high sticks. I'm not...
Either way.
Leggard's gone to find out what that was for.
Either way, the face-off will take place outside the Blaze zone. Over on this near side. Thirty-one minutes gone, 2-0. Kovacka. Selwood. Flavelle will cover that one up as it's dumped into the zone. And it's gone a bit quiet here, Chris. There's possibly the largest crowd ever seen for an ENL game
this
by some distance.
This is definitely the largest crowd to ever see a Coventry ENL Blaze game. Sorry, I have the hiccups. I think those two goals have taken it, the wind a bit out of the crowd. I think the ENL Blaze really do need to get another one in. Well, get one in to try and get the crowd back into this.
And there's a shot from Kovacka. It's free. Flavelle eventually gets some part of his body on top of the puck to cover it.
And I repeat myself again, if they're going to score, it's going to be one of these dirty tip-ins from in front of the net.
Face-off now. Again to the right. And this time Whitley win it. Goes back to Kavaka. Kavaka will dump that in for Leggard. Leggard collects. Over in the far corner, plays it behind the net to McWilliams. But Williams plays it out in front. There's nobody who can get to it, though. And it's 3-on-2 temporarily. Owen eventually puts a hit in. The linesman steps in to separate Owen.
Ali Brummett's going for hooking.
He looks somewhat surprised, does Ali Brummett?
I missed it.
I was watching the...
the play.
Little discussion that Gareth Owen was having. But he will go to the penalty box again for his second penalty, Ali Brummett. Let's hope this power play is more successful for the ENL Blaze than the last one. Certainly the capacity crowd over the far side will hear. Tom Pease collects. Plays across to Venus, playing the point now in the increasingly common system of having a creative forward playing the point on the power play. See it a lot in the NHL and European leagues. Nicklin. Flavelle drops it, his near post and blocks it. And that foot will go all the way back down the ice for Josh Nichols. Now Venus collects. Brings the puck up ice. Finds James Pease. That's offside though. Josh Nicklin overskates it. And I've got to say, Chris, from my perspective anyway, the ENL Blaze are hanging with Whitley, but they're not outplaying them.
No, they are not outplaying them. They're just hanging in. It's, they really do need to do something to turn this around.
You do also get the sense that Whitley can step up another gear if necessary. Can the ENL Blaze do the same? They have to at the moment. They're 2-0 down in their home leg. Venus will collect. Stevenson. Now Venus. James Pease at the point. He'll wind one up. James Pease, that's blocked. And he breaks his stick as well. Could be interesting. Nichols will have to play that one. He does. For Tom Pease. James Pease needs to go and get a new stick from the bench or he'll change. He changes for Kavaka.
Blaze exchanging one cannon for another there.
Unfortunately, that pass doesn't find an ENL Blaze player. The sad remains of James Pease's stick now being brought to the bench. 41 seconds remaining on the power play for the ENL Blaze. 13-12 gone in this second period. They're 2-0 down. Can they find a way back in? Or will they have to do something which I believe no team has done this season and go up to Whitley and win tomorrow?
Yep, no team has done it this season.
Shot from Tom Pease, deflects above a stick and high into the boards.
Blaze really do need to work out a way round the Warrior shot blocking. That has been one of the key defensive points for the Warriors today, is that they have blocked shots and put their bodies between players and pucks as much as possible.
Now, Venus will chase. Owen. Along the boards, Gareth Owen. Wants a loose puck. That's good play from Tom Leggard to feed Owen the puck. Gets it back now, Leggard, by the right circle. Kavaka shoots. It's nearly tipped free, and nobody can get a stick on it. Good play by Gareth Owen. Whitley are back to full strength. Paps manages to avoid Adam Reynolds going full length. He's still free in front of the net. If they can get a shot off, they do. And still, it's chaotic in front of James Flavelle's net.
And Blaine Evans is not going to call 2 minutes for delay of game.
I didn't think he would. Certainly, the ENL Blaze bench wanted it. Whitley desperately trying to avoid the penalty, they managed to do so.
And obviously ENL Blaze, on the other hand, desperately trying to get a power play out of that situation.
So Philip Pollock will take this face off. along with Hubbock and Venus. Pollock wins it. Hubbock shoots. Flavel. Another rebound from James Flavel. Chris said earlier on he's letting some go. There's another. It's still free, Pollock. Can't find the way past that big pad of Flavel, though. And that is now over the far side for the Whitley Warriors. Kippin will collect. Back to Brummett at the point. Brummett tries to get a shot off. Doesn't manage to, though. Checks his stick. Ed Werpman never blames his tools, Alec. Now, Pollock. Beats Watson, but has nowhere to go. Good pass, Pollock. Robert can't control that. He's eventually falls to the ice due to the sliding shot block.
Now, Pollock and Brummett.
Good play, Philip Pollock. He's just calmed himself down, skates away. That was well spotted there, Chris. I was watching the puck in front of James Flavel.
Just doing my job.
A little bit at the back post between Flavel and Brummett. They will both go to the penalty box.
Well, it would appear that the tensions are beginning to boil over in this game.
Reynolds and Paps having a word. Reynolds, for his part, and is trying to work out why.
Brummett and Polly still chattering away in the box.
Polly, normally a quiet and assuming type off the ice, but more than capable of sticking up for himself verbally if he needs to. Pease. But Williams. As the two teams play 4-on-4 for the next 2 minutes. 15 minutes gone exactly in the second period. 4-on-4. And here comes Thornton. Loses control of the puck.
Interestingly, the ENL Blaze during their training sessions over the last couple of Fridays that I've been attending have been doing a lot of 4-on-4 work.
We'll hope it stands them in good stead. But Williams eventually manages to force it down. Brummett now interacting, shall we say, with a block three.
And a blatant trip by Reynolds on McWilliams.
And Reynolds trying to skate away. But he's going to have to go and sit down.
I think if Evans had not called that, the crowd here would have got decidedly, as the song describes, ugly.
Nice. You see? It's not just the ENL Blaze we've been in training this week. We've been in training with our segues and links, and there was a fine example of it there from Chris. 4-on-3 then for the next minute and 10 seconds or so. And I would say, Chris, you've been saying they need to get the next goal. Here's a hell of an opportunity.
This is the best opportunity they have had for the entire period, I think, to try and get one in.
There's a lot of space out there. And I believe the penalties to Brummett and Pollock will
expire simultaneously.
Expire simultaneously. Whether they'll come out the box simultaneously or it'll be counted as a coincidental, we'll see. That's a good play, Daniel Good. He stood out for me tonight for Whitley, quietly doing his job. Owen finds space, lays one off for Tom Pease. Tom Pease shoots, it's free in front of the net. Owen lurking, but Flavel holds on to the rebound.
But good work there by Ross Venus, providing that screen in front of Flavel. He wasn't entirely sure, I think, where it was. As Anne, our announcer, tries to get the fans back into this game.
And There is life over there. You get the feeling a Blaze goal would definitely wake them up. Tom Pease looking to get that at the point. Gates across the blue line, finds his brother James. James back to Tom Pease in space. Pease winds up, shoots and score! Tom Pease with a blue line rocket! And the Blaze are back in the game!
Tom Pease, I said he had a cannon with a bullet from the point. The Pease brothers combine for the first goal of the night for the ENL Blaze.
Oh, you beauty. I don't think Pavel even saw that one. And over the far side, the crowd awakes. The Blaze are back in the game. We said they needed to score on this power play. They have done so. James Pavel has finally been beaten.
Where do we go from here, Chris?
Well, the Blaze need to pile the pressure on. They need to keep pushing forward now and get the second one. If they get the second one, they've got all the momentum going into the break.
So, Stevenson wins that one. And it's dumped in by James Pease. You can see it's even made the announcers excited. The goal scored Tom Pease, assisted Ross Venus and James Pease. 36-05 is the first goal for the ENL Blaze. Scored Tom Pease, assisted Ross Venus and James Pease. So that will wipe out the penalty. The puck leaves the zone. And Stevenson will chase that. He'll win that, Stevenson. That's good, tenacious play. As the Blaze try and get back into the game. Whitley for their part. Try and hold him back. Josh Nicklin, one-on-one. Nicklin shoots, but that's a bit wayward. I think it might have hit a Whitley stick.
Well, Josh Nicklin, we've seen all season long. He can wheel, he can skate, and he can deke.
He nearly manages to do all of it then.
He combines well. I mean, I see the line he's on tonight with Ricky Brynjarski and Michael Stevenson. It's a puck-moving line. All three of them are quite capable of doing those amazing runs down the wing and up the middle with the puck.
And as we say that, how would you describe this line then? They've obviously changed lines. We now have but Williams, Leggard and Owen as the forward line for the ENL Blaze. We said they were a tenacious line.
Well, obviously all three never quit. Owen, you've got the experience, but Williams, you've got the pest in front of the net. And Leadguard, he's good out in the spaces.
I'd say this is the grind line to the skill line of Nicklin and Stevenson. Now, it's back in the Blaze zone, though. Owen having to defend, tries to feed, but Williams. But Williams collides with Kippen. They have a little bit of afters. That's good play by Leadguard. Unfortunately, though, but Williams goes offside. Owen's unimpressed.
So are the crowd.
I think we'll give Blade Evans and the linesman that one, though. 17:42 gone in the second period. We are nearly a third of the way through this playoff final. And the ENL Blaze have announced their presence finally with a bullet from Tom Pease from the right circle after Whitley have had it all their own way, at least in the scoring stakes, for the first half of this game. Now, the puck out in front again. Venus eventually finds Bobby.
Beautiful movement there by Philip Pollock, trying to lay it off and then skipping away. And now he's away for a breakaway.
Unfortunately, Flavelle is alert. So, Bart doesn't get to that one. Here's Windridge, though. He's saying just winds a hard shot up for Windridge. And Josh Nichols will be thankful that was a little wayward, because there was some serious smoke behind that one. Now it's played across and eventually finds Pollock. Goes over to Hubbock. Hubbock tries to lay one back. It's 2-on-2 the other way, 3-on-2. Windridge joining on the far side. James Pease has seen him and lifts his stick as Reynolds tries to feed him. Here goes Venus. Faced by three Whitley players. Venus shoots just wide. You get the sense that the ENL Blaze are getting more and more confident with each passing minute now after that goal.
That goal's given them the momentum and they're carrying it through.
19 minutes gone. We're into the final minute of this second period. 2-1 now. Watson looking for his hat trick. The puck doesn't find him. Harris. Shot Harris. That hits Nichols in the mask and the whistle goes. Kippen is unimpressed because the puck rebounded off Nichols' mask straight to him and he would have just had to slide it home.
Josh Nichols are very, very lucky there, because if Blaine Evans hadn't blown the whistle for it hitting his mask, as painful as that would have been, that's quite possibly saved the Blaze from a momentum-killing third goal for the Warriors.
He's okay now, Josh Nichols. You can't play goalie without expecting a few bangs on the head from time to time. Some would say to play goalie you need a few bangs on the head. Now, Brynjarski feeds Nicklin. Nicklin is blocked off by Bukas, but manages to get to the puck. Brynjarski shoots. Lavelle makes the save.
and Kippin. Watson is checked by Kavaka.
And now the physical game starting up with a hit parade.
There's another one. Kavaka in unaccustomed territory. Goes to the ice as he controls the puck at the same time as someone else. Collides with him. Nichols will have to play that one. Pressured by a Whitley forward, Callum Watson. He just waits calmly. Well played, Josh Nichols. That'll be the end of the second period. So, Chris, 2-1. Would you say it's game on now?
I'd definitely say it's game on. ENL Blaze, a little bit of sleep at the beginning of that second period, but they've definitely woken up now. The momentum is all in their corner.